In this video, I'm going to show you how quickly you can set up animated water using Figment Water Volume 2. I will be using Max and V-Ray, but this is basically a bunch of textures, so you can use these in any 3D program you like. All right, let's load in a texture. This is the entire Water Volume 2 collection, but I'm just going to be focusing on the ocean map and the mono version. So just pick any one of these maps and make sure that you enable sequence down here. This way Max will know that this is a sequence of images and not just a still image. And under the color space, you need to set this to none, as these textures are in linear color space or gamma space. And I will just plug this map into the displacement slot of a V-Ray material. Call that one water, and I'm just gonna select one of the presets here, but I will disable refraction, and yeah, we're good to go. All right, let's add some geometry. Just gonna make a quick plane, 500 by 500, 200 segments. And I'll add a UVW map on top of that. This will basically control the size, placement, and rotation of our texture. And I'll put a standard displace modifier on top of this and set it to use existing mapping. Let's drag the displace map over here into the modifier, put some strength to it, and enable luminance center. This way we should be able to see some water animation already inside the viewport. Quick note, all the textures are designed with the ability to have both slow motion and real-time look to the water animation. So by default, this playback rate of 1 in here, that will give you slow motion. If you want the water to look like it's in real time, simply set this playback rate to 2, and that will skip every second frame of the textures and give you that real-time look. Let's drag the material onto the water, and I'll just set the display type in here to object color so we can still see what's going on. And I will right click on this one and then set this to be off in the renderer. This way this displacement modifier won't be affecting the renderer. For that we want to use the V-Ray displacement mod. And inside this one we're going to be using the object material, so enable this one. That way it will derive the displacement map from the material inside the material editor. And then finally, enable keep continuity so we don't get any gaps throughout our object when it's being displaced. All right, now I'm just going to add a sun and I'll lower the intensity a little bit and let's make a render and see what we have. So it's looking a bit flat right now, and that's because I forgot to copy the settings. So I'm just going to put in an actual displacement amount in the displacement mod in here and set it to, there we go, set it to shift half this amount. And we get some annoying highlights from the sun, so I'll just enable or disable rather the specular. And all right, now we basically have a render of the water that looks pretty fine, but this area is kind of small. So we're gonna go back into the plane and then simply extend it and make this larger. Something like that, and you're pretty much good to go. And just a quick reminder that if you want to rotate or scale the water, you can simply go into the UV map up here and then select the gizmo and then rotate it in here. And then you can change the direction or the scale of the water. And if we just end it here, this is the rendered result. I want to keep this video short, but I just want to show you that if you add a boat, a bit of camera animation, and a sunlight that has a bit more control over the highlights, then you can get something like this pretty quickly. And this is with the exact same water animation as before. Anyway, that's it for me. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have any questions or if there's anything you would like me to cover a bit more in depth, then please let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.